work in an abattoir,
yeah,
is that correct?
Norfolk, yeah.
In which one was that?
Oh, God.
Is it a while ago now?
Yeah. I worked there. There was no other jobs. I went for that job. Mm-hmm. But I didn't expect what I was going in for. So yeah. I went for the job. I thought I'd never get it, but I got the job. I went there. I went to shoot me around the factory. And I said, yeah, the job's for me. Yeah, take the job now. So I took it, and these sort of things, it was like pigs and that. We had to stun them, and sheep, cattle and that, we had to stun them.
So how did you stun them? What was the stunning method?
We used an electric shock on them.
Okay.
We used to put them in this cattle grid, the heads of the cattle grid, when they come through, one at a time. And we used to shoot them by electric bolt.
Is that the prongs?
Yeah, the prongs are for pigs. Mm-hmm. But the other one, the ones for the cows now, the proper prongs, it looks like a bullet when you got to shoot them through the temple.
Right.
But if you don't shoot them through the temple, they'll suffer.
Yeah.
And that's what we used to do. And after that, I used to go through, and I know it's cruel me to tell you, but I should cut the pig's stomach out of them, and they were still alive. You got to cut the throat first.
Yeah.
And they squeal like anything.
They squeal. They make a really, really loud.
They're really
anguish.
Like it's like a baby cry.
Yeah.
That's the same as the the cattle. They're just like a cat crying.
Yeah.
And they're in these sort of pens. There's about 100 ton in a pen. And what you got to do, you got to go down and drag them up by chain. Because they won't come because of the smell of blood. They don't like that sort of thing. But since I worked and all that about 10 years ago, of now, I don't touch no meat, no products, no nothing.
Put you off, because you've seen firsthand how they suffer.
Yeah.
And when the animals are stunned, would you say, does that process always work? Or?
No, I don't know.
No, because you're processing them very quickly,
because
aren't
you? when you stun a sheep, the body, the nerves, are still alive.
Mm-hmm.
But you got to do it quick, because if you don't do it quick, the other sheep behind you, they all get scared and they panic, walk out. But I find it unfair why they have to go through that. Mm-hmm. Human beings would go through that sort of thing.
Exactly.
I don't understand. I know everybody has to eat meat, don't get me wrong, but I think there should be a proper ban on it, where these abattoirs should be all shut down.
Absolutely, no, I completely agree. So would you say the animals, when they are on the way to slaughter, do you think they know what's going to happen?
Yeah, they know, even the pigs.
How do they react? When they
come in lorries like pigs and that, they make hell of a noise. Mm-hmm. They know, and then when they come to us, when the lorries pull in, they go down a big massive chute. And when they get down to the bottom of the chute, they're all different pens. And if the mother has had baby piglets, they take the baby piglets off the mothers, they take them about 6 months before, and then they come on the lorry and they take them down a big massive chute, again all different pens, and then they've got to wait, they can be there for 2 or 3 days, so they smell the blood, start going mad. But when you put them through to the other room, you've got to put the next one in this thing, like a stock, it looks like a stock museum, but they put the heads through there, and then someone comes along, it's two prongs, only small ones. You put them to the side of the head. You've got to hit them quick. If you don't hit them quick, they go mad. Some of them cry like babies. Some of them will go through, and they're not dead.
Yeah.
And they're not dead. And when they get hanged up, when they come through, they've got a big massive tray down the bottom. They just cut the throat and all the blood drips through. But when they go through to the other room, some of them were still alive. You miss them. And they just cut the stomach open and take all their insides. It's a shame.
Terrible, yeah.
It's a shame what people are doing, but I think that this country, the government, should stop all this happening.
Yeah, because we don't need to eat animals.
No, you don't need to eat animals.
No,
anybody can become a vegetarian or vegan.
Vegan, yeah. Because every nutrient we need, we can get from plants.
No, you can get it from plants, herbs.
Uh-huh.
There's plenty of stuff that we can get it from.
Absolutely.
It's the same as chickens. But it's the same as chickens. People just break their necks. No, that's not right.
No, it's not.
No.
They deserve to live, don't they?
Of course they do, like us. They should deserve to live, but they can't. Because people say, people eat meat or that. But no, they don't have to eat meat. They don't want to.
Yeah.
No, they don't have to touch nothing.
Yeah.
But I think it's cruel. I think it's cruel what all these factories are doing. They should be closed down. Or someone should go there and have a look to see what they're really doing.
Yeah. But
they won't
thank
allow
you for
you
that,
in.
Because a
That's
lot
okay.
of the public, you know, these industries are very good at duping the public,
yeah,
into thinking that
do.
It's all humane.
It's not.
And, you know, you've got first-hand experience
yeah.
with this, and you know that that's not the case
no.
at all. I can ask you, how would you say it affected you working in an abattoir?
It affected me a hell of a lot. I'd go and see doctors and everything.
Yeah.
I thought I was going mad. I used to go to sleep and think myself and wake up and think, oh my God, it's blood everywhere, what am I going to do?
Yeah, this is really common. A lot of people don't realise the effect it has.
They don't.
Not just on the animals,
no,
but
it's
on
yourself.
Like yourself.
It's on yourself.
PTSD... So soldiers have the most common rates of
yeah,
PTSD,
do, yeah.
but after that it's people who work in abattoirs like yourself,
yeah,
because you're spending the whole day around violence.
Yeah, all the
you're
time.
You're killing animals who are innocent and who don't want to die,
yeah.
and you're witnessing the most brutal, atrocious things that could possibly happen. So
yeah.
the animals aren't just the victims, it's the people who are working in the industry as well.
Yeah, they should stop it, but they won't stop it. I tried to get, many years ago, I tried to get a factory shut down over this.
Mm-hmm.
In Northampton, I tried to get a factory shut down about killing their products.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, go away. I said, no, why should I go away? You shouldn't be doing what you're doing. I used to work in an abattoir. I know what you're talking about. How about you can come work for me? I said, no, my days are done for that. I'm not working no abattoir again.
No.
So I don't eat meat at all.
That's
I don't
brilliant.
Touch meat. I don't even smell it.
Thank you so much
That's
for
okay.
that. I really appreciate
That's
it.
That's okay. It's nice to have feedback like me.